Hello guys, this is Raven from DJ Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 170. Mohit Goyal has been accused of fraud amounting to Rs. 41 lakhs. Goyal was arrested by Noida police on August 23rd on Monday. Mohit was arrested by the police back in January for defrauding dry fruit traders for Rs. 200 crore. CEOs from Amazon, Apple and Microsoft reportedly plan to meet with President Joe Biden on Wednesday to discuss on cybersecurity. This meeting follows several high-profile cybersecurity incidents. FM WhatsApp 16.80.0 has been found infected with the Triada Trojan. This malware can pop up ads on the infected device, can even sign up for the user for paid subscriptions. Kaspersky warns users not to download and install such modified versions of application, especially WhatsApp. WhatsApp's upcoming feature will let you react to the messages. You can place an emoji on a message to express what you feel about it. The message reactions feature is already available on Instagram, Twitter, and iMessage. Disney Plus Hotstar is all set to introduce new plans starting from September 1st. Users can log out from any device that was logged in if the platform after verifying using the one-time password. The benefits for Disney Plus Hotstar premium users will remain unchanged, with the added benefits of being able to view shows on four devices. The Disney Plus Hotstar VIP will be discontinued. Starting September 1st, Disney Plus Hotstar will offer three new plans, including mobile at ₹499 per year, super at ₹899 per year and premium at ₹1,499 per year. Realme GT Master Explorer Edition is likely not coming to India. Francis Wong, Realme CMO, confirmed the same on Twitter. Realme launched the GT Master Explorer Edition in China. The HomePod Mini customers and Indian music lovers, as now they can use Siri hands-free to play JioSaavn and Gaana Music catalog from the application installed in your Apple iPhone or iPad. According to the latest update, the HomePod Mini will battle against the smart speaker available in the market. And a lot of these smart speakers offers to add these music streaming services as a default on their platforms. Krafton has permanently banned 271,880 accounts from August 13 to August 19. There have been many complaints regarding hackers entering the lobbies using illegal ways to kill players. This demotivates the players and also promotes the users to such illegal programs in-game to enhance performance. These bans have been put last week, where these Battlegrounds Mobile India users were hacking in the game. Smartphone companies keep looking for partners to assemble devices in the country. Similarly, Reliance Jio, which is all set to sell its first 4G smartphone, the Jio 4 Next, has reportedly joined hands with the UTL Neolink for assembling its devices. The company is likely to bring 5 million units with UTL Neolink. Redmi will launch new true wireless earphones along with the Redmi 10 Prime. This upcoming offering is expected to be a rebranded version of Redmi 8.3. The true wireless earphones will be powered by a Qualcomm processor. Xiaomi's sub-brand Redmi is set to launch true wireless earphones on September 3rd in India. Deezo, the first brand under Realme's Tech Life, has launched multiple products in the few months since it began business. Now it has been teased a new product, which we believe it is a soundbar. And this soundbar may be a successor or a more affordable model to the Realme 100W soundbar that launched last October. And we can also expect it to have a support for many connectivity options, including Bluetooth, AUX and coaxial. Realme Narzo 50A design renders have been leaked online. According to the render images, the Realme Narzo 50A will have a dual-tone design on the back. The left half of the phone has a diagonal lines, whereas the right side has a smooth finish. The rear panel houses a large camera module. It not only houses a triple camera setup, but also has a rear-mounted fingerprint scanner. OnePlus Note 2 Go Green Woods Color will be on sale in India from August 26. This phone will be available via Amazon and OnePlus websites. Samsung Galaxy M32 5G has been launched in India. The key specifications include a 6.5-inch display, Dimensity 720 processor, 48-megapixel primary camera and a 5000mAh battery. Samsung Galaxy M32 5G price in India is set for ₹20,999. Samsung Galaxy A21 has caught fire inside the cabin of an Alaska Airlines flight after landing at Seattle Tacoma International Airport. This led the crew to deploy the aircraft's evacuation slides to remove the flight's occupants. The passengers' phones overheated and started the fire after the flight from New Orleans landed on Monday evening. According to the reports, the Port of Seattle said that a total of 128 passengers and 6 crew members were transported by a bus to the terminal. Fortunately, there were not any serious injuries associated with this fire. According to the recent rumors, have revealed that Apple is working on a major design overhaul of its upcoming iPad mini tablets. Now, renders have revealed these major changes in the design while also highlighting some of its key specifications as well. The upcoming iPad mini will basically be a more compact version of the fourth generation of iPad Air with a 8.4-inch liquid retina display. The display will also have a 60Hz refresh rate and a uniform bezels. And it will be available in space gray, silver, rose gold, green and sky blue color options. This iPad mini render sports a Cupertino-based Giant A14 Bionic chipset. Vivo X70 Pro 5K renders and a 360-degree video reveal the complete design of this phone. This handset comes with a punch-hole cutout, quad cameras, curved edges, and an in-display fingerprint sensor. Vivo X70 Pro specifications could include a MediaTek Dimensity 1200 processor, 12GB of RAM, and Android 11 OS out of the box. Xiaomi 11 Lite 5G NE global variant spotted alongside the Indian variant on IMEI database. NE moniker could stand for new edition. Xiaomi 11 Lite 5G NE is speculated to use a Snapdragon 778G chipset. A new Oppo foldable smartphone is seemingly expected to launch soon, and its commercial unveiling may happen rather soon, at least in global markets. According to the reports, Oppo is seemingly ready with a bunch of hardware and software, for which it may host a launch event soon. Of all this hardware, one of the biggest attractions will reportedly be an Oppo foldable smartphone. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.